الحمد لله، الله سبحانه وتعالى granted us to be from the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored his beloved Habib صلى الله عليه وسلم beyond understanding, beyond comprehension. And evidence of this is that when Allah asked the believers to make salawat on His beloved, He says, "Ya ayyuha al-musta'in billah, inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala an-nabi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima." When Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. When Prophet explained, when they asked him, "We know how we make salam, but how can we say salawat on you?" He showed them that you ask Allah to make salam. You say, "Allahumma salli 'ala Muhammad wa 'ala ali Muhammad wa sallim." Indicating that because we don't know who Sayyidina Muhammad is, we don't know his qadr, we don't know his status, we don't know, and his bashariya is only a ray, Maulana used to say, from that sun, his human manifestation amongst us. But he is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only his Lord knows him. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows qadr al-Nabi. That's why we can't say, yani sometimes people in their dars you say, usalli wa usallimu ala. You say, I make salah and I make salam, the teacher or the... But if you say usalli, you're making salawat on your qadr, on your estimation, on your understanding. Huh? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, make salawat on him. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows the qadr of his habib. He can make salawat on him. We ask. So, yani, there's no way to explain what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been granted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by us. We know, لو ناسبت قدره آياته عظما أحيا سموه حين يدعى دارس الرمم. Imam Busayri said, he said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really showed us that if he made the signs of his being in front of us according to his qadr, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أحيا سموه, he said, you say Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم on a dead thing and it will become alive. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لم يمتحن بما تعي العقول به. He doesn't want to test our limitations. Because we know what happened with our Christian brothers and sisters when Sayyidina Isa brought things back to life and so forth. They said he is Allah, astaghfirullah, حاشا ثم كلا. So, why we're making this introduction? Because everything connected to that Habib becomes honored. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are khayra ummah because we are ummat Sayyidina Muhammad. We are followers of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then our qadr increases automatically because of him, not because of us. خير أمة, the best nations. What about his progeny? What about his family? We gained honor by our nisbah to spiritually acknowledge what he brought us of realities, to acknowledge that increased us. What about the ones who are also connected physically to him? What about their qadr? That's why Prophet ﷺ said, he indicated that his connection to them and his relationship to them and his love for them. When Sayyidina Ali came one time, walked in and Prophet's face lit up. He saw him, and Sayyidina al-Abbas was sitting next to him, his uncle. And he said, do you love him? He says, لله أحب. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. قال النبي, he says, لله أحب له مني. أو كما قال النبي, he said, Allah loves him more than I. More than I do. And he said that he made my progeny, he says all the prophets' progeny was in their own being, but he made my progeny in this one. And prophet's love is not from his own. When prophet loves, it's by Allah's love. When he gives attention to somebody or shows love and care for somebody, it's because it's already Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that one. So when he gave so many hadiths about his love for Ahlul Bayt, for Sayyidina al-Hasan al-Husayn, أحب الله من أحب حسين, and Hasan, Sayyidina al-Hasan, Sayyidina Fatima, how much love he showed them and care. And he said, I want to know all this khair you are receiving. We don't know what we are receiving until if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to live on khair, on goodness, and then we will see the khairat that Prophet ﷺ was the cause for us to receive. But he said that, love my family. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. I was only one thing I'm asking you is to have wood. Wood is even deeper than love. It's real love. It's for my family. So today is a day of victory. It is a day of delivery. Sayyidina Musa was delivered on this day, alayhi salam, from, and his entire nation, from the hands of Pharaoh, Pharaon. Even in Athar, they say many of the great victories Allah gave to his prophets came on Ashura. And Allah chose that day that the last sibt, sibt al-Nabi, sibt Sayyidina Muhammad, sibtain, they call him, Sayyidina al-Hasan al-Husayn, alayhi salam, that the last sibt on earth until Judgment Day, there is no other grandson after Sayyidina al-Husayn, because there's no other prophet besides Sayyidina Muhammad, was martyred on Ashura with his entire family. Then how do you put the two things together? It's a day of victory. Yet the Ummah found it in it. For Sayyidina Musa found that itself looking at a real blemish on its history. That Sayyidina, the grandchildren of Prophet ﷺ were killed by people who were saying La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. How is that? How can you accommodate the two? It's a day of victory, and then this happens to Sayyidina al-Husayn and his family. Because we are short-sighted. We don't know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his hikmah in things, his wisdom in things. An example is Shaytan alayhi ma yastahiq. Shaytan was jealous of Sayyidina Adam. He wanted him out of paradise. He wanted to show his bad one. He didn't want him to receive any of the gifts and favors. So he schemed to take him out. And Shaytan wanted to bring down Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. And his scheme worked, and Sayyidina Adam was came down to, but in this was Allah cursed shaitan and threw him out of. But in this, he made his this إني جاعلك في الأرض خليفة. Sayyidina Adam was given khilafah because of this. So the maqsad of shaitan was to bring down Sayyidina Adam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sha'an, Allah's will, Allah's irada is something else. So when something, he wanted to bring up Sayyidina Adam, make him khalifa. Similarly, every age has its pharaohs, every age has its Yazids. Yazid did what he did to the family of the Prophet, thinking that he is diminishing them, or diminishing their light, or erasing their light, or finishing them, or I don't know what was going on through his not very well mind. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this instance wanted to honor Sayyidina al-Husayn. Yani this incident could happen on any day of the year. It could happen in Safar. It could happen in... Allah chose Ashura, a day of victory. You'd have to plan this. Back then, if we are trying to make a meeting between two people, today is easier. Back then, with distances and travel, to make it happen on Ashura is Bishara for Sayyidina al-Husayn and his family. It's glad tidings that I am honoring the last grandson of the Prophet with martyrdom, fasting, fighting for truth. Ajab. With his entire family, madloom, oppressed. So on that side, it is ta'zim of Sayyidina al-Husayn. It's ikram of Sayyidina al-Husayn and his family. Until Judgment Day. Who knows those people who came out to fight him? And the ones that are known, everybody curses them. Till today, we remember the sacrifices of Ahlul Bayt and Sayyidina al-Husayn and those who... So for us, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, our mashayikh, they teach us to see things in the true light of... that this is not diminishing of Ahlul Bayt in any shape, way, or form. This is not a defeat when 72 stand in the face of 4,000. What kind of fight is that? Even if these 72 lose, they win. They stood in front of an army. The blemishes on the army that allowed to fight children and women, 72. And this is happening today, as you see. The Yazids are never ending. And the pharaohs. Where you have Muslims, masakin, they have nothing, facing world powers. Ajib. So the question is for us is, when it comes to Ahlul Bayt, is we love them, to honor them, to respect them, because they are our ship of safety. أحب الله لما يغذوكم من نعمي وأحبوني لحب الله وأحب أهل بيتي لحبي أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث that you must love them. يعني the three loves are mentioned: love Allah for what He gives you of favors, love His beloved because He is Rasulullah, Habibullah, He's the most beloved. He's connected to him. And then love the family of Prophet for the love of Rasulullah. It's not three separate loves. It's one love. Loving the family is loving the Prophet, is loving Allah. You can't love Prophet Allah and not love His beloved. How are you going to do that? You can't love Prophet ﷺ without loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? You love just for his person in this dunya? No, he is Rasulullah ﷺ, eternally, Nabiullah. So, Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah is we honor, this is how we honor the sacrifices. We come, we make dhikr, we make salah ala nabi, we pray, we fast, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to when things happen, when difficult things happen, what did he do? He prayed. Arihna ya Bilal, he used to say. Relieve us, O Bilal. When things are heavy and hard, he said, run to pray. So when we do these events, we're calling people to dhikr, dhikrullah, to remember the sacrifices of Ahlul Bayt, because we are recipient of all this goodness. The reason why we Islam reached us in the way it has today is because of all the sacrifices of this Ahlul. And I mean not exclusively Sayyidina al-Husayn, Sayyidina al-Hasan, Sayyidina Ali, Sayyidina Hamza, all the companions who, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, all the sacrifices all the companions did. And the struggles they did, and the selflessness with which they served the way of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is the reason why we are receiving now this religion the way it is. So if we show gratitude for them, man lam yashkur innas lam yashkur illah. These are our masters. All of them are our masters. Alhamdulillah. Sayyidina al-Hasan and Sayyidina al-Husayn are our masters in heavens. So aren't they our masters on earth? If Allah granted. So inshallah we will do zikr and then we will recite Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, the names of Ahl Badr, Ahl Karbala, the Shuhada of Karbala. And we will ask their intercession, because we believe they are, like as we said, all the signs, yani Sayyidina, they've already been given the siyada. Sayyidina al-Husayn has already been told he is Sayyid of Shababi Ahli al-Jannah. Huh? Before he showcased his, in these trials for the Ummah, not just for the, Allah showcased what kind of metal they are made from, that they are asiyad. So we are, Ya Rabbi, we are happy with our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are happy to be from his ummah. We are happy with his companions. We are happy with his family. We are happy with his grandchildren. We are happy with anything connected to the Prophet in a good way. We are happy, Ya Rabbi. We are weak ones. And if we are tried and tested, we'll probably fail, Muslim. But our claim is that we hope to be lovers of these alams. We want to be with them. We want to be with Sayyidina al-Hasan, Sayyidina al-Husayn, and all the companions. Wa min Allahi tawfiq bi hurmati al-Habib, bi hurmati al-Fatiha. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن